Hey there everyone, and welcome to another video. And today we are talking about one of the very favorite subject, which was requested by a lot of people when I visited to a university just a couple of days ago, in fact just last day. So this is all about web scraping using Python. So there was an interesting discussion that happened, and I just wanted to deal up with this through a YouTube video. So the agenda here is we're going to talk about the web scraping using Python. And this is not a more advanced video. Probably we can do that in the next upcoming video, but this is like the basic startup building a guide. And on top of that, we can probably do a couple of videos more. So let's talk about it. First of all, what is web scraping and what are the caveat points that you should take here? Now, web scraping is when you want to extract some of the important data from the website, you can use web scraping, and when the APIs are not available. Usually the ideal way of picking up some of the data is through API, which is recommended and which is like the best way of doing the things. But sometimes it's a little gray area, because web scraping is not legally allowed on most of the website. Again, you have to check from the website owner or the policies of the website. So it's a gray area. Yes, I will get that onto that. So make sure you are totally aware that what you are doing is completely legal, because I have seen in the past that web apps and especially mobile apps, especially on the Android as well, are being shut down just because they were using web scraping, and the user or the website owner was not aware that you were doing web scraping there. And yes, it's a gray area. Still, a lot of companies do that. You'll get a job for web scraping quite a lot. So leaving that gray area apart, let's talk about the web scraping. So we want to pick up some certain data from the website and how you should strategize to that. We'll discuss in that. We'll give a simple example in here, and then we'll move on to the complex example in later on videos. So first thing is, we will be using Python, because Python is ridiculously fast as well as easy to do these kind of web scraping. In fact, most of the tools of web scraping they are present in the Kali Linux are being designed in Python. That's a simple step. And the first thing that you should always do when you want to do web scraping is go onto the website and analyze this website. Just onto a side disclaimer, I don't allow anybody to web scrape onto my website. Since this is my website, I can do that. Go ahead, do that on other website, okay? So the first thing is analyze the website, because web scraping, a lot of people think, is all about using the regex and all these stuff, but it's not. It's all about how you understand the web data structure, how the things are laid out, because it's moreover like a CSS thing. Because developers, you have to understand the developer first, because let's just say you want to pick up all these highlighted like titles and all of that. So obviously we can see that there is a lot of similarity. Maybe you want to pick up all the data from this button, and we can see all these buttons are almost similar, colors are different. So there might be some internal CSS which might be picking up all these things, and that's exactly what you have to do. You have to analyze the website. Don't just start up your editor and start writing and code on that. Just spend a lot of time on the website, try to understand the detail, the architecture, the structure, and how the website is being laid out. It's gonna be super helpful for that. Moving further on that, we'll be using Python 3, and we'll be just grabbing a title from this website. I know that's a ridiculously basic thing, but we'll be moving forward on that as well. So the first thing that you should be aware of, what kind of packages you will be needing with the Python. Obviously, it depends on what you really want to do. Maybe you want to save that in the Excel document, so that requires a variety of different things as well. For right now, onto a very basic start, you need packages like requests, and this is all available, free packages here. So first one is request, and the most important one is the beautiful soup. The beautiful soup is like the whole meat part of what you need for the web scraping. They have amazingly great examples on here. You can check them out. Amazing website, amazing documentation. The reason why we cannot totally be dependent on Beautiful Soup is Beautiful Soup can do a variety of things, but cannot make a request onto a web page. So just to make that request, we'll be using requests and then the Beautiful Soup here. Now, it depends on what you want to do. That kind of packages is totally onto you. Maybe you want to save that as an HTML. Maybe you want to save that as a CSV and all of that. So enough of the theory. You learned a little bit basics. Of course, we'll be using Python 3, because hey, who uses Python 2 now? So let's just go back here. So the first thing that I'll be doing is running a Python shell, because if you're on a Windows, you can run the IDLE, I-D-L-E, and that's it. So first thing that we'll be doing is import request, And in case your request is not available, because right now my it doesn't say any errors or warning, yours might give you. So what you can do is, you might have already learned that in my Python course, we're gonna say pip3 install. On Windows it's just pip install. Since I'm on a Mac, it's pip3 install. And then you can simply say requests and it's gonna install the stuff for you. It's really quick. Mine is already installed, so it just says, hey, why you need to do that again? Similarly, you can install the beautiful soup as well. So without any wasting much more time, let's go into Python 3. Okay, so we're gonna import requests, and we are gonna also import BS4. This is beautiful soup. Okay, so how we can proceed with that? The first thing, you have to make a request to the website from where you want to do parsing or maybe kind of a scraping there, of course, legally. Let's just create an object or variable res, and res is going to make a request. So we're going to say res dot requests, and that request can be passed on to, and of course, let me just get back here. Res is going to make a request onto that. It's sometimes hard to write and type here. So it's going to make a request there, requests.get. And this is how you make a request. And we're going to say https://learncodeonline.in. There we go. And of course, you have to type your all quotes and everything because it doesn't suggest you. So this is the first step. You make a request, and now your res, your variable, is holding that request. Okay. And there we go, that's it. So if you check out this res now, there we go, it's an object of request which is storing all of your things. Okay, so the next thing that we are going to do is, we're going to use this res, because if you just say res dot text and just check it out, it is storing our entire web page. And just to give you a simple example here, here is my Instagram ID here, so a lot of meat information is there. So now we do have a variable which is storing like all the source code of the web page, but this is not usable. It's just like saving and all of that. So we need to extract information for that. And here comes the beautiful soup. Again, everything what I'm doing here is mentioned in the documentation and stuff. So I highly recommend you to look for it. This is how everybody does the stuff. So let's just do a basic stuff. And we're gonna create another object from the beautiful soup, which is soup. Let's just call this as soup. Now this soup is going to use BS4 or beautiful soup 4, BS4, and we'll be using an object or a method here, which is beautiful soup. Make sure you take care of the case sensitivity here. Now this beautiful soup takes two parameters. The first is that object we have created just right now, which is res dot text. This is the first one. And the second one is how you want to structure your data, because there are a lot of structure that beautiful soup support, which is HTML parser, LXML, and maybe you, whatever you want to do. In this case, I'm going to be using LXML. And again, just for a sidebar here, LXML also need to be installed. So in case it gives you an error, go ahead, do that pip3 install LXML for Windows, pip install LXML. So there we go. Now, what is going to happen? Previously, this res.txt was an object of type request. Now we are converting it into an object of type beautiful soup. Okay, this is exactly what you're doing. And if I just go ahead and type this as soup, there we go. Now it is, soup is an object of class BS4 beautiful soup. This is a very important step. Okay, now you can do anything what is mentioned in the documentation of beautiful soup 4. For an example, we just want to extract title in this particular video, but surely we'll take that on to step further, maybe in the later on videos. So let's just create a new variable, and let's just call this as hi. I'm not good at naming the variables much often, but bear with me. So we're gonna simply say soup.select, oops, I can write the select, come on, select, and then you can pass on whatever you want to select. And here you can pass on HTML tags. Yes, all of them are available here. In this case, I know this title is a very unique tag and it's just available once. So there we go, we have it. Of course, you can pass on anchor tag, but that's not at all a good strategy to extract all the links from a website, but just to give you an idea. And now, if I just check what is inside this hi variable, it gives me a list of all the objects, okay? So if you're parsing like maybe a class or maybe H1 tags, it will give you an array of all these tags. and then you can maybe loop through it and all of that, okay? And just to give you an example, if I want exactly, there can be many, I can just simply say hi, and then I can simply request for the first object from this array, and there you go, you got that. If you want to extract the text of it, you can just use the get text method, okay? I can type that shortly. Get text, okay, and it is going to give you the text. Now the single quotes are there because I'm onto a console based Python stuff, but it's really easy. Okay, so this is like the basic stuff, how we deal up with the things. Maybe you want to loop through all the values, and maybe you want to store that into a CSV file. It's all a step-by-step thing, okay? And surely if you want me to talk a little bit more about this beautiful soup stuff, this parsing the stuff, we can make one more video on that. And we can talk about the extraction based on the classes and IDs and how things should be done. Just onto a sidebar, yes, you can use all of your regular expression and all these stuffs with a beautiful soup as well. But regular expression is kind of a stuff which is like a last weapon that you should take out. A lot of things that you can deal up with is that can be pretty easily done with the CSS selectors and classes and IDs, all of that. So do let me know if you want me to talk a little bit more about these web scraping and how to do some fun web scraping as well. I can surely do that. Let me know in the comment section that if it is interesting or not, and surely we can make more videos on that. So this is it. I hope you have learned something about it. Python is amazingly simple, amazingly awesome. And go ahead, check out the description section as well. That's it for this video, and we'll catch back again in the next video. Hey, don't forget to subscribe my channel as well.